Hello, this is Swati Mali and this is a video about knowledge engineering process. After going through this video, the students are supposed to understand the steps in knowledge engineering and be able to apply the steps to any given problem. There are 7 steps to knowledge engineering. First one, identify the task. Then assemble the relevant knowledge about the task. Decide on vocab of predicates, variables and constants for the task. Encode general knowledge required for the task. Encode problem specific instance given. Then query the knowledge base to get the results. And if the answers are not accurate, debug the knowledge base. Repeat steps 6th and 7th until you get the correct. The first step in knowledge engineering is to identify the task. This is equivalent to goal formulation step in the problem solving. So in this particular step, we decide what the agent is supposed to do. For example, in crime mystery solution, the goal for the agent could be find the motive of the crime or find all the suspects involved in the crime. It could be list all the victims, or it also could be find out all the lies the culprit might have stated. The second step is to assemble relevant knowledge. So in this particular step, we collect all the common sense knowledge of the model or the world in which the agent is supposed to work. So this is typically the information on how the world evolves. Like again in crime mystery story, what are the typical crime motives, or how the crime stories are solved, or how the world around the victims and culprits work, etc. Information could be taken as the how the world evolves information. So this may contain the information on how jealousy may make people to commit crime, or also the information about how the offices are not working on holidays. The third step is about deciding on vocabulary of the predicates, variables and constant. After the goal formulation in the step 1 and knowing how complicated the world is from step 2, one can decide on knowledge to be coded for the given problem. This step gets completed with a list of all the predicates and their argument types. Variables and constants, those will be used in the program. So these variables, predicates and constants combined together are called vocabulary of the solution. The next step is to encode general knowledge for the given problem. Once the vocabulary is decided, the assembled relevant knowledge is encoded as rules. These rules are encoded using some knowledge representation language. These rules can be used with any other problem of the similar type. So these are not specific for one problem, but are generic information about a certain world. The next step is to encode problem specific instance. So here, the problem specific information, that is the facts, are encoded using some knowledge representation language. This part of the solution contains all the facts in the given problem. The last two steps of knowledge engineering are query the knowledge base to get the results, and if the answers are not accurate, debug the knowledge base and repeat steps 6 and 7. So the knowledge base is defined as collection of facts and rules. So in case if the answers are not correct, then one has to identify if the facts are complete or even the rules are complete, and accordingly get the answers.